Dear viewers, I welcome you to the class 10 of heat exchanger. Before coming to this class 10 of heat exchanger, you should have completed your class 9. So in the class 9 of heat exchanger, you have studied NTU, the derivation for parallel flow heat exchanger, which was connected to class 5 and 6, right? In class 5, you have studied LMTD for parallel flow. In class 6, LMTD for counter flow. Class 9, it was NTU for parallel flow. And now in class 10, I'll be explaining NTU for counter flow heat exchanger. Just like the previous video, I'll give you the changes that has to be made from class 9 to class 10. Fine. So before coming to class 10, you should be aware of class 5, 6 and 9. Okay. And whatever you have studied in class 5 and 6 regarding LMTD, this you must be referring. So same thing you need to write in main exam. You cannot skip this. You need to write all these things till equation number 2. This you will get in class number 6. Okay. So now coming to the NTU for counter flow heat exchanger, from this LMTD write all this procedure except assumptions and take equation number 2. Fine. That was theta 2 by theta 1 equals e power minus NTU into 1 minus e. This is what you will be arriving at. For more clarifications, you can have a look over here. This was equation number 2. For parallel it is plus, for counter it is minus. This minus sign is carried forward till here. And this equation number 3, I have taken it directly. Fine. So this is the equation number 3. From this equation, replace theta 2 and theta 1 with the help of the temperature variation. So this is parallel flow and this is counter flow. So now theta 2 is TH0 minus TCI. I have written it. And theta 1 is THI minus TC0. Take the same. Now what was the hint for us? In class 9 it was, hint was to express the outlet temperature in terms of inlet temperature. Write the same equations, effectiveness, which is ratio of Q by Q max. Write the same things, arrive at these two equations, TH0 and TC0. Now substituting these two values in equation number 3, in this equation, in equation number 3, if I substitute TH0 and TC0, TH0 was THI minus epsilon into THI minus TCI. Where did we got this? From here. From this. I am substituting TH0 and TC0 here. So now TH0 has been replaced. TCI carried forward. THI carried forward. TC0 has been replaced. Done. So minus TC0 in this sense. Minus of TCI minus epsilon into C. So this will be minus. Okay. And now, if you carry it forward, take THI minus TCI as a common factor. Okay. If you take THI minus TCI as a common factor, I'll get 1 minus epsilon. And here I'll get this minus is carried forward. So this will become 1 minus epsilon into C. So multiply this, having cross multiply, 1 minus epsilon equals 1 into this factor minus epsilon C into this factor. Fine. Now make these two as LHS. Take these two to one of the side and epsilon terms to the other side. So I'll get epsilon minus epsilon C into e power minus NTU into 1 minus E. So now taking epsilon as common factor, LHS, this part remains same. 1 minus e to the power minus NTU into 1 minus C. Fine. And here taking epsilon as common, I'll get 1 minus C into e to the power minus NTU into 1 minus C. So this is your final expression for efficiency, effectiveness for a counter flow heat exchangers NTU derivation, in other words. Fine. So there ends almost all the analytical part of heat exchanger. I'm ending up all the videos of heat exchangers. If you have any queries, you can write me at munna_faruk@yahoo.com. Fine. If you have any queries, you can write me over here. I'll reply you for your doubts. Fine. Max to max, I might have left some theoretical part like design parameters to be taken into consideration, folding factor, that you can go through your books. If you want any video regarding those parameters, kindly write me at munna_faruk@yahoo.com. Thank you for watching all the videos. Thank you again.